introduction before handing it over to you. So good morning to all of you, and good morning to Dr. Muruga Bhupathi, who has joined us from Rajapalayam for speaking about the topic optimization technique using RSM for proportioning of FRC. So just before I introduce Dr. Muruga Bhupathi, let me just introduce the organization and then the initiatives that we have taken over the past so many days. The first and the foremost thing, as all of you know, I just, for the sake of repetition and for the information of everyone, we have 12 brands of cement, which is coming from our various cement plants that is situated in the southern part of the country, as well as in Kolagat, in Odisha. We have a grinding unit which is coming up. So the idea of this various brands of cement coming up is very interesting, because this is based on the customer's interaction that we have got. See, the thing is that we have Portland Pozzuolana cement as per IS 1489, Portland slag cement IS as per IS 455, ordinary Portland cement as per IS 269. Then we have rapid hardening Portland cement, the Ramco Superfast, and we have the SRC cement. So the idea is that, you know, there are various applications, as all of us know. Concreting is being applied in various places. You have the foundation concrete, the roof concrete, you have the column concrete, then you have the plastering, then you have concreting for various structures, and then you have concreting which is being made in various ways, sometimes site mixed concrete, sometimes ready mixed concrete, where it is being transported and things like that. So based on this feedback, if you see, we have four Portland Pozzuolana cement, out of which Ramco Supercrete cement is specifically meant for concreting applications. This has been designed for that. And the basic characteristic of Ramco Supercrete cement is that it is having a high rate of gain of strength and at the same time low heat of hydration. So the idea of, because all the customers wants a concrete which gains strength very quickly and at the same time it must not crack. So that is where you know, Ramco Supercrete cement, by virtue of its low heat of hydration, helps everyone. But this does not mean that you should not do curing. There is always this perception that should we do curing or not. Yes, you must do curing for all the kind of concrete. So this is what we have, and two Portland slag cement we have got, and we have got the OPC 53 grade infra is used for concrete with longer slump retention, and wherever sulfates are there, one can go in for sulfate resisting cement. And for all the precast units in the southern part of the country, hollow block manufacturers, solid block manufacturers, well ring manufacturers are using Ramco Superfast, because it's economical. And the second thing is that they are able to get high rate of gain of strength. So we have seen, based on the actual experience, you know, by the precast units, they have been able to get all the benefits. Of course, we have the dry mix range of products also, which is specifically meant for non-structural applications, tile fix, block fix, Ramco Superfine, tile grout. And this particular dry mix plant, which we have at Sri Perambudur, is established in collaboration with MTech Germany. Which is, again, this is only meant for non-structural applications. So that we need to be very clear. And we have the Ramco Research and Development Center, which acts as a bridge between the customer's requirement as well as, you know, the theoretical concept. So it is very important that we bring the theoretical concepts onto the field. So that is where the Ramco Research and Development Center helps us. They do a lot of works on cement and concrete. Analysis of a lot of blending materials, analysis of various types of cement, compatibility study of cement with various kinds of admixtures, concrete mixed designs, various concrete grades ranging from M10 to M100 with a lot of permutations and combinations. As all of us know, M20 can be made with you know, slump retention of half an hour. It can be made with slump retention of 2 hours or more than 2 hours. Where it has to be transported. Then we have the self-compacting concrete, which has to be made so that it doesn't segregate. So works of this kind is being done at Ramco Research and Development Center. And ours is the only company which has got the Four Leaves Award for leadership in technology, leadership in utilization of blending materials, and for leadership in points. Some of our few customers, major project customers, ranging from ITD Cementation, Lassana Dubro, Tata Housing. Then we have various project customers in the eastern part of the country, various institutions, Bangalore Metro, Chennai Metro. So they all have been using our cement, and most of this, all these places, our brand is also approved. So this is what you can see. You know, say for example, it can be near the port, near the sea, it can be near the city, it can be a multi-storied building, it can be a chimney, it can be, say for example, a refinery project, it can be thermal power project, nuclear power project. So each of these projects, you will find that the concrete required is different. You know, like say for example, nuclear power project, you need high density concrete and things like that. So that is why this customization plays a very vital role. Now let me just come to the speaker of the day. Let me introduce him, Dr. R. Muruga Bhupathi. He graduated in civil engineering from PSNA College of Engineering and Technology, Dindigul, after which he completed his master's in structural engineering from Thyagarajar College of Engineering, Madurai. He obtained his doctoral from Anna University, Chennai. He has a total of 22 plus years of experience, of which 20 years in teaching and the remaining industry. So Dr. Muruga Bhupathi has published two books on engineering mechanics and theory of structures, and he has published 10 papers in various national and international journals. So he has got the best IST chapter secretary award in the year 2006, a gate scorer with high percentile in the year 2007, and is the best outgoing PG student award 2009 from Thyagarajar College of Engineering, Madurai, and university first rank ME structural engineering from Anna University, Tirunelveli. So this is about the speaker of the day. And he would be sharing with us about his research topic that he has done during his doctoral program. And I'm sure that construction professionals will benefit from this. And a lot of takeaways will be there. And this is the 76th webinar that we are having. And I am sure that the series of webinars that we are organizing would be useful for construction professionals, students, academicians. And this can be viewed on YouTube as well as Facebook Live. So please make use of this series of presentations, whichever presentation interests you. And if there is any kind of queries, please don't hesitate to get in touch with us. So with those few words, let me again welcome Dr. Muruga Bhupathi to start off with this presentation. Over to you, sir, Dr. Muruga Bhupathi.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
The third button, share content. Yes, it's getting loaded. Okay, sir, please go ahead.
Okay, thank you, sir. Very good morning to all my friends and my young budding technocrats, those who are attending this wonderful webinar organized by our Ramco Cements Limited, Chennai. Ramco Cements in Indra Pandamam Kuda Urudhiyanadhu Dhaan. On behalf of our management, our CEO Dr. R. Venkatraj sir, our principal Professor V. Srinivasan sir, our HOD Madam Mrs. A. Prabha, and the faculty members of our PSC Ramaswamy Rajapalayam College Rajapalayam, I heartily welcome you all for this national webinar on optimization technique using response surface methodology for proportioning of fiber reinforced concrete. Stay at home and save your family. Prevention is better than cure. Noyatra valve, prevatra selvo. Agenda. So in this webinar, we are going to look at this following area for a period of nearly 50 to 55 minutes duration. I think it may be a new work to you, and I hope it will be helpful to you in your construction field. Now I am going to discuss on an introduction about concrete. All we are very well known about concrete. It is a composite material and it containing consists of coarse aggregate, that is gravel, fine aggregate, sand, cement, water, and any admixtures if it is required. So we know the functions of ingredients. Coarse aggregate, it is used to provide the strength of concrete. Fine aggregate, which is used to fill the voids between the coarse aggregate, so that it is called as a filler. Cement is a binding material, we know very well. Water, it is a reaction agent, it will generate the heat to the concrete. In modern trends, the utilization of cement plays a vital role for the manufacturing of concrete. Therefore, the utilization of cement is increasing in the construction of civil engineering field. Therefore, the utilization of cement is increasing in the construction of civil engineering structures like industries, house, flyover, water retaining structures, earth retaining wall, landing strip, and road pavement. Agricultural industrial waste. Today, large volume of agricultural pipe product such as groundnut shell, comb cup, sawdust, rice husk, coconut shell, and the industrial waste such as ground granulated blast furnace slag, fly ash, silica fume, metakaolin, etc., are directly disposed on the land without doing any further treatment. A little quantity of these waste materials was efficiently used, but most of them were not fully utilized. These waste materials are dumped on the land and thus create illness to the peoples and the animals, and also making nuisance to the environment. Byproduct waste materials. These are obtained from various agricultural and industrial byproduct waste has an excellent pozzolanic properties. The partial replacement of cement with ash of waste materials plays a vital role for making concrete. The concrete manufactured using these waste materials increase the mechanical properties due to the improvement of the microstructure of the concrete. Also it decreases the permeability due to alter the pore structure of the concrete. Objective: the environmental pollution caused by the waste materials and the price of cement has induced several scientists and the research to looking for the most appropriate alternative supplementary cementing materials for the replacement of cement. The objective of this work was to investigate the effective way to partial replacement of cement with these waste materials for the production of concrete by minimizing the environmental pollution and controlling the cost of construction. Selection of pozzolanic material. In this work, the following waste materials were used as a pozzolanic material for the replacement of cement incorporated with wool fiber: groundnut shell ash, that is an agricultural byproduct, and GGBS, it is an industrial byproduct. About groundnut shell ash, India stood second place for the cultivation of groundnut after China. In India, approximately around 10,000 tons of groundnuts are produced annually. The Gujarat holds first place for the production of groundnut in India, with a share more than 50%. Andhra Pradesh stands second place with a percentage of 12.69%. The groundnut shell is discarded after the nuts are removed from the oil mill industries, and then it is burned in incinerator at high elevated temperature from 600 degree to 800 degree Celsius to get groundnut shell ash. Constituents of groundnut shell ash. The groundnut shell ash contains high percentage of silicon oxide, calcium oxide, potassium oxide, sodium oxide, and aluminum oxide. The groundnut shell ash is an excellent pozzolanic material. In the past, it was used as a stabilizing agent for the stabilization of soil. Properties of groundnut shell ash. They act as a good substitute material for the replacement of cement in the construction industry, and it will help to reduce the cost of construction. These are light in weight, therefore they can be used for the produce lightweight concrete. The compressive strength and flexural strength can be increased using the groundnut shell ash for the partial replacement of ordinary Portland cement. The concrete prepared by groundnut shell ash provides better durability performance and will provide the high toughness. They provide better resistance against chemical attack. Among the various agricultural waste, the groundnut shell ash has an excellent pozzolanic material since it reacts with calcium hydroxide to produce calcium silicate hydrate paste and forming tensor microstructure. Many researchers reported that the consumption of groundnut shell ash up to 10% will provide the effect in the manufacturing of structural concrete. It shows the ground cell as image of ground and the image of ground cell as GGBS. It is a byproduct which is obtained from the iron industries. It is also having a good pozzolanic property. We know that the ore obtained from iron industry, coke and limestone are fed into the furnace, and the resulting mold and slag floats above the mold iron at a temperature of about 1500 degrees to 1600 degrees Celsius. It is an excellent replacement for the replacement of cement, since it has remarkable advantages when compared to the performance and behavior of usual OBC based concrete, in addition with environmental and ecological gains. It consists nearly 40% of calcium oxide and 30 to 40% of silicon dioxide, which resembles very close to the composition of ordinary Portland cement. Properties of GGBS are: it improves workability of fresh concrete, it reduces the permeability of concrete due to fill-up pore structure of concrete, it increases the resistance against sulfate attack, the chloride penetration is reduced, the liberation of heat during the hydration process is also very less, it's chemically stable, it enhances the strength of concrete and improves the durability of concrete, and therefore the lifespan of the concrete structure will be increased. Selection of GGBS. Many researchers found that the consumption of GGBS up to 50% could be beneficial effect in the manufacturing of concrete. The presence of GGBS in concrete when reacted with water and sewage forms CSH paste and produce tensor microstructure of the concrete matrix. It helped to enhance the strength and durability of concrete and increase the performance of concrete structure beyond the service life. It shows the image of GGBS. Types of fiber. Different types of fibers are available in the market. Some important types of fiber which is available in the markets are steel fiber, glass fiber, carbon fiber, and polypropylene fiber. Some other special types of fibers are available in the market, such as mineral fiber, asbestos, and natural fiber. The natural fibers are economically extracted from animals and vegetable plants, such as coir, sisal, palm, jute, hemp, banana, bamboo, and wool. Selection of wool fiber. The fiber selection depends on their cost, properties, and availability. Out of the above mentioned fiber, the wool fiber is one of the natural fiber, and the wool fiber is available in free of cost and is easy to spread. Wool fiber is a natural hair grown on sheep and is composed of protein substance called as keratin. Wool is composed of carbon, hydrogen, and nitrogen, and this is the only animal fiber which contains sulfur in addition. Wool fiber is distributed as randomly in the concrete. Properties of wool fiber. They are composed of amino acids. They have excellent absorbency. Moisture regains is very high. They have very good resistance against acid. They have good elasticity and resiliency. This image shows the wool fiber. Physical properties of materials. Cement. So these are all the properties of cement. If you look at the properties of this cement, all the parameter is very close to the limits which is given in the IS code. Here we can see standard consistency is 31%. The range is to it should be 30 to 35%. Setting time, initial setting time on 12, that is more than 30, and final setting time 213 minutes, which is less than 600 minutes. The specific gravity of cement which is used for this work is 3.13, that is within the limit. And the fineness, 312 square meter per kg, and that is more than 225 square meter per kg. And the size of the cement is 10 to 90 micron. That should be less than 90 micron as per code provisions. That is also within the limit. And fine aggregate, the specific gravity 2.55, fineness modulus 2.8, Unit weight of the fine aggregate is nearly 1675 kg per meter cube. Absorption of water is 1.75%. Surface moisture 2%. Coarse aggregate, specific gravity 2.72, unit weight 1723 kg per meter cube. Absorption of water 0.75% and surface moisture nil. Water, the pH value of water which is used in my project is 7.8, that is within the limit, and organic solids 112 milligram per liter, that is less than 200 milligram per liter. Inorganic solids, sulfate, chlorine and suspended matters, all the parameters are less than the requirements as per IS 456-2000. Then superplasticizer, that is the properties of superplasticizers are active solids, color, specific gravity, air enrichment, pH value are like this. And granulate cellulose, the size of the granulate cellulose, that is 10 to 75 micron. Specific gravity 1.93, finest modulus 4.93, and the unit weight is very, very less, 1090 kg per meter cube. Finest 329, that is more than the cement, 329 square meter per kg. And also GGBS, size which is varying from 10 to 45 micron, specific gravity 2.75, bulk density 1170 kg per meter cube, and the fineness also higher than the cement, 342 square meter per kg. Wool fiber, the diameter of the wool fiber is 0.05 mm, length of the fiber is 25 mm, and the unit weight 350 kg per meter cube. So mixed design for M20 grade concrete. In this work, I have been used M20 grade of concrete. So the M20 grade of concrete has a design based on the IS 10262-2009. Here I have used one part of cement, 1.89 part of fine aggregate, 3.22 part of coarse aggregate, and water cement ratio is 0.55. Preliminary test on concrete. So in this project work, I have been utilized two experiments. One is cube compressive, another one is prism flexural strength test. For cube compressive strength test, I have been used the specimen size as 150 mm by 150 mm by 150 mm. And that is crushed using compression testing machine with 200 tons capacity. And also prism has prepared the size of 150 mm by 150 mm by 700 mm, and it is tested in the UTM, which is 60 tons. Mixed proportions of the concrete for preliminary study. In the preliminary study, I have been prepared nearly 9 group of samples. Out of this 9, the very beginning, the very first one is control specimen, that is 100% cement. And others P1, P2, P3, P4, P5 are the cement replaced by the GSA with 2, 4, 6, 8, 10%. And in this group, P6, P7, P8, these three category, both GSA and GGPS has used to replace the cement with respect to this percentage. From GSA from 6 to 10%, GGBS from 20 to 50%. This is the testing arrangement of cube compressive strength. And the cube compressive strength can be found out by using this formula, F is equal to P by A. So from this bar chart, we can understand that for the controlled specimen, the cube compressive strength is 25 Newton per mm square. And if you look at other group of specimens from B1 to B8, all the specimens has reduced for 7 and 28 days water curing, except B7. So this B7 is slightly more than the control specimens. The compressive strength of this B7 category is slightly higher than the cement mortar. The B7 specimen is 57% of OBC, 8% GSA, and 35% GGPS. And this photograph shows the testing arrangement of prism flexural strength. The prism flexural strength can be found out by using these two formulas. We know very well about this. The bar chart representing the prism flexural strength at the age of 7 days and 28 days for the controlled specimen. So the 28 days prism flexural strength is 4 Newton per mm square for the controlled specimen. But if you are looking all other replaced specimens, all the specimens has reduced than the controlled specimen. From P1 to B5 category, all are reduced. If you are looking this B7, that is also getting lower than the controlled specimen. Now, general discussion. It was observed that while replacing the cement by 35% of GGPS along with 8% of GSA, there was increase in compressive strength of concrete at the age of 7 and 28 days curing as compared to the conventional concrete. At the same time, there is no any improvement in the prism flexural strength of concrete at both 7 and 28 days. Therefore, it was suggested to include a small amount of fiber, that is wool fiber. The size of wool fiber is 0.05 mm diameter and 25 mm length, and it is placed randomly. The percentage of wool fiber is varying from 0.1% to 0.5% along with GSA. The GSA percentage is varying from 6 to 10, and GGPS, it is varying from 20 to 50% to improve the prism flexural strength of the concrete. Since we are using three different materials like GSA, GGPS, and wool fiber for the replacement of cement, it is planned to utilize the statistical technique of optimization using response surface methodology with CCRD. CCRD means nothing, central composite rotatable design, to minimize the preparation of many numbers of concrete specimens. Optimization technique using RSM. The response surface methodology is a most extensively used tool in the statistical design of experiments using Design Expert software version 8.0.7.1. It is a collection of mathematical and statistical technique useful for the modeling and analysis of the problems in which a response of interest is controlled by several variables, and the purpose is to optimize this response. Selection of significant and experimental design using RSM. In this optimization technique, the most reliable method of response surface methodology with CCRD was employed to optimize the dependent variables such as pure compressive strength and prism flexural strength of concrete at the age of 28 days pre. The CCRD was applied to examine the optimum proportions of strength of concrete with 5 level and 7 factors. The independent variables, namely GSA 6 to 10%, GGPS 20 to 50%, and wool fiber 0.1 to 0.5%. The fixed coded levels of each independent variables are minus 1.68 to minus 1, 0, plus 1, and plus 1.682, 5 level. Experimental parameters and the range of coded and actual parameter of CCRD. Here you can see these are all the parameters. These parameters is called as independent variables. The independent variables are GSA, GGPS, and wool fiber that can be denoted as X1, X2, and X3 respectively. Here, factors. The factors may vary from 0 in the left side, minus 1, minus 1.682, at the right side, 1.682. Okay. And the percentage GSA 4.6, 3, 6, 6, 8, 10, 11.36, and GGPS varying from 9.77, 20, 35, 50, 60.23, and the old fiber 0, 0.1, 0.3, 0.5, 0.683. This zero level is the median 8, 35, 0.8. From here minus one step, and this side minus 1.68 step has to be moved. Fitting the models based on the preliminary experiments results, small number of concrete specimens were cast with respect to the experimental design. The various mixed proportions of concrete are shown in the table. We can see in the next slide. The prepared concrete specimens were investigated to find out the cube compressive and prism flexural strength of concrete, and also to find the effective way to replace the cement with waste materials. The experiments were performed within the parameters, and their ranges are as shown in previous table. So this table shows the experimental response for CCS and PFS. Here, the control specimen. The control specimen will not be given by the software. And the others from right from 1 to 20, from right from 1 to 20, the software will give the software will give the mixed proportions. So for these mixed proportions, for trial 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and up to 20, we have to prepare the specimens in three numbers for the each trial, and we have to induce for the testing, and we have to obtain the values. So that values to be entered in the tabulations here, experimental value O1. Now we are going to discuss step-by-step procedure to analyze the responses using Design Expert software. So this is the Design Expert software homepage. So in this, so we have to click on DX7 trial, then we have to click on OK, then next. So we can choose the new design page, or otherwise we can open the previous work. So we have to click on new design for new analysis. Then here we can see these are all the methods, that is technique, combined technique, response surface methodology, and factorial. Those are all the technique which is used in the optimization. So we are going to fix the two level factorial, so that we have to click on two level factorial, the next central composite. So in that two level factorial, we have to click on central composite, and next we have to enter the numeric factors. The numeric factor, that is nothing, independent variables. Here we are going to use three kinds of variables like GSA, GGPS, and wool fiber. Those are the waste materials. Those are all the parameters used to be under here in percentage unit. The level varying from minus 1.6 plus 1.10, minus 1.20 GGPS, and plus 1.50 GGPS, and in minus 1.0.1 and plus 1.0.5. Then we have to choose rotatable. So that is central composite design. On that central composite design, the rotatable design will give the exact value, so that we have to click on rotatable, then OK. 20 runs will give by the software. Right now here, then these are all the parameters, dependent parameters, dependent variables, that is called as responses. So we have to enter these all the tools. CCS 28 days in Newton per mm square, and PFS prism flexural strength 28 days in Newton per mm square. Next. So these are all the trial mix is given by the software. That is already I have in the very beginning table. So this MITS trial is has given by the software design expert. So for this trial, we have to prepare the specimens and we have to test on the specimen. Right, and next, that is. Next, we have to enter the appropriate experimental responses. Then we have to go next slide. Here we have to click on design and that design summary. Design summary. So the software will generate the design summary for this particular work. Then next. Next, after the summary, we have to click on crop columns. So we can see crop columns with respect to GSA and GGPS, GSA and CCS. And also evaluation. That evaluation, we can go for model, results, graph, etc. Then we have to click on analysis. In that analysis, we can see here there are two responses are there, dependent responses. So CCS 28 days and PFS 28 days. Then we have to click over CCS 28 days. Then we have to go for Y transform. In that Y transform, we have to choose none. The next one, fit summary. In that fit summary, we can get the response. Then model, then ANOVA. In that, this is very important one. This is the ANOVA model. In that ANOVA, ANOVA is nothing, analysis of variance. So in that ANOVA, we can conclude whether the design work is significant or not. Whether the design work has within the limit or not. So from this ANOVA table, we can know about the reliability of the test. Here it is significant. Here also it is significant. The model F value of 1252.66, 1252.68 implies the model is significant. And the value of F less than 0.5 indicate model terms are significant. In this case, A, B, C, A, B, A, C, B, C. A is GSA, B is GGPS, C is wool fiber. AB is the combination of GSA and GGPS. AC is the combination of GSA and wool fiber. BC is the combination of GGPS and wool fiber and A square, that is GSA square, B square. B square is GGPS square, C square. C square is nothing, wool fiber square are significant model terms. The value greater than 0.1 indicates the model terms are not significant, but here all the values are less than 0.001, so that the model is significant. This is the final equation. The final equation in terms of coded factor. In terms of coded factor, we can obtain by using this coded factor. We have to develop the equation for the second order polynomial equation. Next one, we have to click on diagnostics. In the diagnostics, we can get the graph, normal plot residuals. The normal plot residuals graph has drawn with respect to internally student residuals and the normal percentage of probability. From this, we can understand that all the specimens were within the limit. There is no any higher deviations. This is predicted versus actual. This is very, very important graph. So predicted versus actual response graph. And another one is contour graph. And another one is 3D surface graph. Like that, we have to click on the PFS 28 days and we have to get the ANOVA modeling. Finally, we will get the final equation in terms of coded factors. Okay, next, like that we can get the graph. Then we have to click on optimization. In that optimization, numerical optimization, set goals for each response, then click on solutions to generate the optimal conditions. Graphical optimization, set minimum or maximum limits for each response, then create an overlay graph highlighting an area of operability. Point of prediction, enter your desired, that's very, very important. Point of prediction, enter your desired operating conditions and discover your predicted responses values with confidence intervals. Next, we have to click on the numerical, that numerical GSA. The GSA value is varying from 6 to 10, we know that. Then the GGBS is varying from 20 to 50. And the wool fiber is getting varying from 0.1 to 0.5. And also GGS 28 days, the minimum cube compressive strength is 13.35 and the maximum is 29.74. And BFS, prism flexural strength, the minimum is 2.23 and the maximum is 5.71. This for only the percentage replaced GSA by 6 to 10%, GGBS by 20 to 50%, and wool fiber from 0.1 to 0.5%. Okay. Now, point of prediction. Here, this table, we have to enter whatever values, what you are missing, as what you are expecting, that value you can enter in this box, and you can get the appropriate GS cube compressive strength and prism flexural strength. Here, I have been entered for the value of 830 and 0.3. Already, we castered the cube specimen and prism flexural specimen for these values, and we got the appropriate strength that has been entered in the table previously. So we can check in the next table, we are going to check the values. Now here we have to enter 0.30%, that is GSA is 0.3 and GGBS 30% and wool fiber, this is for wool fiber 0.3. So the cube compressive strength for this percentage is 23.90 Newton per mm square, and prism flexural strength for this percentage of replacement is 5.60 Newton per mm square. And also you enter another value, 830.5, and you can get the CCS and the BFS value. Then 630.5. Results and discussions. So like that, we have to enter for all the mixes, and we have to find out, we have to predict the value CCS and BFS, and that should be entered in the tabulations. Now we can look at the table here for this 16.23 cube compression. At the same time, we are getting 15.96, very, very close value. Like that, we can go on all the trial mix, and we have to generalize the equations of RSM. This is the generalized equation. That generalized equations can be converted into like this. Right. Here, Y is dependent variable, that beta, dependent variable such as cube compression and prism flexural strength. And beta 1, beta 0 is the model constant. Beta 2 is, that is, beta 0 is the model constant. Beta 1, beta 2, and up to beta 33 are the model coefficients, where x1, x2, x3 are the coded value of independent variables such as GSA, GGPS, and wool fiber. The second order polynomial equations can be converted into like this. That is, already I told you, that is, from that coded factor value, we have to develop this equation for CCS 28 days and PFS 28 days. validation by ANOVA. The experimental models were validated by ANOVA and to find the coefficients of the individual responses and the regression coefficients of the obtained equations. The significance of the responses was monitored by F-test and the B-value at 95% to 98% confidence level. The experimental variables likely significant and more suitable if the F-values become higher and the p-values become lower. The p-values were used as a main tool to check the significance and adequacy between the interaction of the variables. A p-value less than 0.05 specifies that the coefficient is statistically significant. If the high value of regression coefficients R-square is greater than 0.8, is a good fit. The predicted R-square values is to be higher than response surface methodologies adjusted R-square values. So effect of compressive strength of the concrete cube. The model equations CCS 28 and ANOVA table for CCS 28 days shows that the quadratic term of x1 square, x2 square and x3 square followed by the linear term of x1, x2, x3 and the interaction term of x1, x2, x1, x3 and x2, x3 have significant effect. That B value is less than 0.05 for cube compressive strength of concrete at the curing period of 20 days. It is evident that the cube compressive strength of concrete at the age of 20 days was due to the combined reaction of groundnut cellulose, GGBS and wool fiber. Both react slowly together and help to develop the compressive strength in the latter age. Normal percentage probability plot for studentized residuals for 28 days, CCS 28 days curing. Figure shows that a normal percentage probability plot for involvement of X1, X2, as well as X3, and these variants are normally distributed and so no deviation. P-values for lack of fit were 0.0001. R-squared value that is equal to 0.9991. RMS, adjective R squared value is 0.9983, so that this experiment is significant. The high value of regression coefficient R square greater than 0.8 is a good fit. This signals that the model is considerably fitting one. It has higher R square values of compressive strength at the age of 20 days, where 0.9991 compared to RSM's adjective R square value is 0.9983. This figure shows that the relationship between the experimental and the predicted values for cube compressive strength of the concrete at the age of 20 days curing. Now, the 3D response under the contour plots shows the significant effect on cube compressive strength of the concrete at the curing age of 20 days for the partial replacement of cement. The figures of 3D response surface and the contour plots CCS 20 days demonstrate that the partial replacement of cement with 7.2% of GSA and 30% of GGBS corresponding to the highest cube compressive strength of concrete cube at the curing age of 20 days were 26.1 Newton per mm square. When the wool fiber was held at fixed level, that is zero level, that is 0.2%. The CCS 20 days for a control specimen is 25 Newton per mm square. And the effect of flexural strength of concrete prism. The results of ANOVA table for PFS 20 days and the polynomial equation PFS at the age of 20 days curing shows that the linear term x1 and the quadratic term x1 square, x2 square and x3 square were significant. That is p value is less than 0.05. for the prism flexural strength at the curing age of 20 days. It is strongly evident that the prism flexural strength of concrete is because combined action of GSA, GGBS and wool fiber. Normal percentage probability plot for the studentized residuals for PFS 20 days. Figure shows that a normal percentage probability plot for involvement of X1, X2 as well as X3 and these variants are normally distributed and also there is no any deviation. B values for lack of fit were 0.0001, which is also less than B is less than 0.05. Moreover, the predicted data against the experimental data has a higher R square value of 0.96973 compared to the RSM's adjective R square value, that is 0.9378. And 28 days of curing this, okay, and the obtained high values of regression coefficient, R square is greater than 0.8, is an indication of good fit. The 3D response surface and the contour plots shows that the maximum prism flexural strength of concrete at the age of 28 days curing were 5.6 Newton per mm square of effective replacement of cement at 7.2% of GSA, 30% of GGBS, and 0.2% of wool fiber. The prism flexural strength at the age of 28 days per control specimen were 4 Newton per mm square. This is higher than the specimen which is replaced by 7.2% of GSA, 30% of GGBS, and 0.2% of wool fiber for the replacement of cement is giving better results than the control specimen. The lack of fit F value, F is equal to 1252.68 for CCS and 32.84 for BBS, and the lack of fit B values for P is equal to 0.0004 for CCS and 0.0008 for BFS implies that the quadratic models for all the independent variables were highly significant. Therefore, the GSA, GGBS, and wool fiber as a good alternative and without changing the properties of cement and minimizing the cost of construction as well as environmental pollution. Verification of model. So we have to verify the model. For that, we are going to predict some values. So control specimen is giving the same results, and we are going to find out the cube compressive strength and the prism flexural strength for these kinds of trials. So we have to start from GSA 8%, GGBS 35, and wool fiber 0.3. Then we can reduce the values or increase the values, whatever may be. Then we have to predict some values and we have to do the experimental analysis. Next. Now here, we are predicted the predicted value of these responses. Then we have to do the experimental test for these kinds of setup. Okay. RSM, CCRD, verification of experimental and the predicted value for CCS and BFS at the age of 28 days. Here, so these are all the predicted values. So after the prediction value has obtained, we are going to guess the cube and the prism for these trials, and we have to get the values. And if you look at the values, all the values are very close to the predicted value. Here you can look. CCS 26.08, which is very nearer to 26.10, and the CCS 25.19, that is 25.17, 24.02, 24.01, like that you can see all the values. And like that, a prism flexural strength, 5.61, 5.6, 5.63, 5.62, like that. Now from this setup results, we can understand which one is best one. Here, if you have looked this one, 7.2, 30.2 is giving the better results than other specimens. Here the compressive CCS for 28 days for this trial one is 26.10, and the prism flexural is 5.60. And here when it is replaced by 7.2% of GSA, 35% of GGBS, and 0.2% of wood fiber, that is giving 25.17 Newton per mm square as CCS, and 5.62 is the prism flexural strength. From these two, we can choose any one. So compression is higher than this. somewhat higher, but the prism flexural is very, very close to this, so that we can choose this one. 7.2, 30, 0.2 is the optimized value. The suitable verification experiments were carried out to check the reliability of optimization of the partial replacement of cement. The previous table shows the verification of the experiment under the optimum conditions based on each individual response with predicted and experimental values. The experimental results shows that the replacement of cement with the GSA, GGBS and the wool fiber has significant effects on the maximum cube compressive strength and prism flexural strength of the concrete at the age of 20 days. This experimental design understood that there was a good fit between the experimental value and they are predicted by the regression model. The optimized results were obtained at GSA 7.2%, GGBS 30% and wool fiber 0.2%. Conclusions. The following conclusions were made on FRC by partially replacing the cement with waste materials such as GSA and GGBS in addition with wool fiber. The study explains the feasibility of using waste materials such as GSA, GGBS and wool fiber for the replacement of cement. The study also demonstrates the reduction of environmental pollution, minimizing the usage of cement and cost of construction. On the basis of the preliminary study, 8% of GSA and 35% of GGBS showing cube compressive strength of concrete was increased. At the same time, the prism flexural strength of concrete was decreased. Thus, it is incorporated with the wool fiber to improve the flexural strength of concrete. Further, the optimum mix proportions to obtain the maximum strength of concrete were predicted using the optimum technique by RSM with the CCRD. From the ANOVA second order polynomial equations of the Pittard model, it is concluded that it is evident that the cube compressive strength of concrete at the age of 20 days was due to the combined action of GSA, GGBS and wool fiber. Both react slowly together and help to develop the compressive strength in the latter age. It is strongly evident that the prism flexural strength of concrete is because combined action of GSA, GGBS and wool fiber. The specimens replaced with GSA 7.2%, GGBS 30% and wool fiber 0.2% has better mechanical properties such as cube compressive strength and prism flexural strength of concrete, and the cost of concrete may be reduced up to 10% approximately. With the scope, this work was carried out only by incorporating the wool fiber alone to improve the flexural strength. Flexural strength of concrete containing GSA and GGBS. Further investigation may be required to examine the effect of GSA and GGBS using other type of fiber. The durability performance tests on concrete are to be carried out. In this work, an effort has been made to predict the optimum mix proportions to obtain the mechanical properties of concrete by optimization technique using RSM with the CCRD. This research work may be prolonged further to compare the results with other optimization techniques. If anybody wants to invite me for further webinar talk, I am ready to deliver the guest lecture on the following emerging trends: concrete technology, green wall construction, emerging trends in concrete technology and construction practice, hands-on training on mixed design of concrete, rehabilitation and retrofitting of RCC structure, design of composite elements. Distance makes us stronger. Varumun kaapadai vida varamal kaapadai mel. Veetileye irupom vilagiye irupom vidiyum poludhu kooda namakkaga than endru kaathe irupom. Thank you. I would like to express my sincere thanks to our management for giving permission to give talk in this national webinar. I extend my profound thanks to Ramco Cements Limited, Chennai, for giving chance to me to give special talk on optimization technique using response surface methodology for proportioning of fiber reinforced concrete. I wish to extend my graduate towards Engineer Anil Kumar Pillai sir, Engineer Suraj Kumar sir and Engineer Karthikeyan sir for given constant support to me to give talk without any difficulty. I thank one and all those who are directly or indirectly involved to organize this webinar successfully. Finally, I would like to thanks to all the participants for patiently listen my talk throughout the span of this webinar. Thank you. Thank you all.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
Dr. Murugappupathi, for that presentation. I'm sure that many of the budding students as well as faculty would have got a lot of ideas on this, and they would be able to do more work on this topic.
Surely,
and what
sir.
We would be doing is that questions, if there are there, we will be sharing it to you by email. That's okay?
Okay, sir. Email, okay, sir.
Email is okay. And we would also like, you know, so many topics you have got for webinar and all. It's very interesting,
yes,
that
sir.
You are doing a lot of works at the college.
Yes,
nice
sir.
To hear
yes.
that. And,
you,
you know, if suppose we have a lot of webinars like this, this is one way where we can share our learnings with each other.
Yes, sir.
So for that,
sir.
We would like to thank you because for sparing your time. I hope the classes are going online. So, you know, instead of that, you have
yes, been,
yeah,
yes, sir.
You
yes.
Have,
yes.
Yeah. Taken up time from your busy schedule to be here with us, so we would like to thank you for that. Thank you, Dr. Murugappupathi, for that wonderful presentation. And
you,
we would like all the construction professionals, there is one announcement. Next week we have a series of webinars in collaboration with ACCEI Chennai Center, and on 13th of July we have Dr. Shekhar who would be coming and who would be talking on 3D technology in concrete technology. So that would be his topic. And then from 13th to 16th, we have this webinar. So we have the following speakers next week, just for an idea. We have, Dr. M. Shekhar, 13th July, from 11 to 12 noon, 3D printing technique and its application to concrete construction. Then on 14th of July, we have Engineer A. Karthikeyan, Foundation Failure Causes Prevention and Remedies. Then on day 3, we have Dr. Colonel Nalathambi on Good Construction Practices in RCC Buildings. And on 16th July, we have Dr. V. Rajendran, who would be talking about brainstorming session on repairs and rehabilitation. So please, you know, look for these talks next week. And thank you so much. Thank you for all the construction professionals who had logged in. Thank you, Dr. Murugappupathi, and thanks, Dr. Mr. Suraj Kumar, for hosting the session. All the best. Thank you so much. Stay safe. Thank you.